guys are all having a wonderful day. Lately, we've been talking about ping pong.
Hey, your pants are falling down.
Oh, sorry about that. He just said my pants are falling down. Who else thinks that? We're heading over to my friend's house. My friend Jeb Corliss, he's a daredevil. He base dives, he dives with sharks, he's doing the wingsuit thing. You name it, he's done it. Got 3 stories in his house, and he's got a rope between like the stairs, and every third day he can only use the rope to go between the floors. And he's got a ping pong table, so we're really gonna throw it down and find out who's best at ping pong with these dudes.
What?
Jesus.
Coming in hot on the pizza boy.
Yeah. Pizza boy.
So who's good at ping pong? Have you seen the clip of Bruce Lee play ping pong with nunchucks? Alright, let's go to Jeb's. Let's do this.
This is where we came surfing, Jesse. El Puerto Beaches.
Nice.
Which is a famous surf spot, according to Wikipedia. I got the facts.
Late in the day. Ready to hit this house of fun?
Yeah, rope climb boys.
What up, what up? What's up?
How's it going,
Mike? Look at it, this is the rope I've been talking about.
Every third day I'm only allowed to use that to go to my room. Like the first time it's not so bad. Third time you're like, okay. By the 10th time you're like, oh God, really? And then you like really start making decisions based on what, you know, do I really need to go to my room?
Yeah. We've been talking about ping pong. Like over at the office, we've been talking trash. Who's the best?
Who is the best?
Obviously
we don't
me.
Know.
I've been telling these millennials and kids about you guys. Look how rough this shark looks. Who took this picture?
I did. That's a 10 millimeter right after I took that picture, it hit my camera.
Was it before or after the fight you guys had?
I jacked him up pretty good.
I want to get these guys into shark diving.
I'm super down.
Jay-Z's kind of like in the back.
I'm good on the sharks thing.
Well, come on, man.
I can deal with like panthers. I don't know about sharks.
Do you guys want to see this? I mean, I want to go. That's on my bucket list, is to dive with sharks. And I'm taking you guys with me. You've always pushed your limits. What's the goal? What do you do? What drives you into doing all this?
Well, when I was younger, I had a lot of people tell me that the things I wanted to do weren't possible. You know, when you're a little kid, you tell adults, you know, I want to fly or I want to be in the water with sharks. And their first reaction is, well, you're young, you know, when you get older, you're gonna realize that those things just, they're not possible, like people can't do that. And as I got older, I started realizing that all of those people who told me that my dreams were impossible were wrong, you know? And I started becoming obsessed with this concept of turning those dreams into reality. So my whole life has been coming up with concepts and ideas of things that I wanna do, and the more people tell me it can't be done, or it's impossible, or it's gonna kill you, or the more I'm like, oh, really? Well, let's make it happen. So a big part of my life has been now just turning dreams into realities. And it's kind of cool to have to turn that kind of into a job, where all of a sudden your job is coming up with a dream, the more bizarre, the more strange, the more complicated, the better, and then making it real. Yeah. Schools teach you that you need to get good grades so that you can get into a good college, so that you can get a good degree, so that you can get a job. It's all about getting a job so that you can make money. Where what they really should be teaching you is, who are you? What are you? What is your passion? What makes your life have purpose? Why do you wake up in the morning, drink water, eat food? Why do you do these things? And then once you figure out what your purpose is, what your passion is, then you go do that. And then guess what happens? When you do something that you're passionate about, you put 100% of yourself into that, and then you get good at it. And then when you get good at something, people will pay you to do it. It doesn't make any difference what it is. It can be fixing cars, taking care of kids, dancing, singing. Pick something. They'll pay you to do it. I mean, I get paid to jump off buildings. I mean, who gets paid for that shit?
You're just good.
That's what it is. That's what dudesonism is about. That's what we've been like. We were told that, you know, cut your hair, get a real job.
Yeah.
Do what you want to do. Be and find out who you are. Right?
Right.
All right. Now, let's start playing.
A couple warm-up exercises. Joe, you ready?
I'm standing here.
Cool.
Ah, my eyeballs! Why are my eyes always in Oh my god.
I'm warmed up. I'm sweating. I got two shirts on.
Well, this is with paddles. Wait till you do it with frying pan.
You ready?
I'm ready. Okay, so this is everybody's name. So we'll pick who's playing the first game. And then these two people play the second game. And then the winners will play each other. But after you know you're playing, you have to pick one of these, which is your paddle. Which is either going to be a frying pan, a spatula, a shoe, or a phone.
Right. Whose shoe we do it with? Not Joey's, because I don't want to smell it.
It's a flip-flop.
Oh, flip-flop would be great, yeah. All right, so.
What's the flip-flop?
Want to pick two names?
Okay.
The first name.
Joey versus Yuka.
Oh, all right.
All right, now pick what you're playing with.
Come on, shoe.
Play with your own shoe.
The spatula's
gonna
be tough.
Spatula!
Oh! What do you got?
A shoe! That's like even the worst one. All right, we're playing.
How you feel about the spatula, Joe?
I'm indifferent.
Very sure?
Oh!
2-0, now Joey, sir. Oh! 0-3. What does that mean? Oh, you got a point. 10-3, game point.
Spatula, bro.
It's a tough.
I like your shoe. Mike, I might just keep it.
Yeah, you can. Your shoe turned against you. Oh, that's game.
Spatula.
With all of my hands.
Smell that. Smell, that's your shoe.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so Yuka advances to the championship.
I'm in the finals. Who wants to go first?
Oh, okay. I'll pick first. My hand does smell bad. Spatula.
Shoe! what do I even want?
Yeah, if you want.
Yeah. Spatula, no!
No, the same item!
Damn you, spatula!
This is just for serious, I'm just rallying.
Good game.
God.
I can see Paul so mad at the spatula right now.
3-10.
But perhaps.
How mad are you right now?
I'm fine. It's you versus Yuka, bro.
Let's pick new things. This one's not easy to play with. I'm hoping I'm not getting that for finals. JC, you want to pick first?
Sure.
It's the grand finals. Spatula.
I just want the shoe again. I feel so comfortable with the shoes.
Shoe? No!
What? Pan.
Okay.
Ooh.
I got this.
You grab that chair?
Come on.
Hey, don't let that shoe beat you, all right?
I don't think it'll pan out for him, though. Yeah, they already
have a chair. They already have a chair.
We got ourselves a game, boys. Oh.
I remember JC saying he's the worst at ping pong, and then you give him a flip flop. And...
1-1.
Oh, God, I beat like the 200 game.
It's like, I don't want JC to lose, I want the shoe to lose.
Thanks.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
There is one. Am I one away?
What?
I just won?
You just won, bro.
I didn't even know. High shoe, bro.
Good job, bro. Really good game.
Wow. Seems like a long ass way.
This is madness.
You want to be wearing shoes on this one.
I used to climb without shoes, but you see that scar? It drilled a hole through my foot. Okay, so there's two methods. I mean, I don't know if you guys ever watch like CrossFit and stuff, but there's like different methods of locking the rope with your foot. So a lot of them, what they'll do is they'll put the foot on one side, come up, and then put the other foot on top of it. I pinch with my feet. And then...
and he gone.
What a way to motivate yourself, like having that up here.
I was kind of hoping he would go like way quicker and make it look like really easy. It's like cool. It's like he's that quick. Like yeah, let's get it. But that didn't look,
he can tell that he needs some strength and some technique. I'm gonna do it. I got this.
God, this is a long freaking way.
Oh.
Oh, I got
it. God, I gotta cover, even when you're on a rope, I gotta cover my neck.
Oh, yeah.
Looking hello, good, Nico. Bro.
Welcome to the stratosphere.
I'm in space!
Beautiful.
Nice work. Back
to the roof. Woo!
Wow. Good job.
Good one, buddy. Oh, nice work.
But I want to see how these guys do. Yeah, I wouldn't have that. I wouldn't visit upstairs too often if I had that in my house.
What's you think? So is he going to make it, Jed?
You look strong.
I don't have a lot of weight to carry. Yeah. I have that advantage. I honestly don't know if I've ever climbed a rope. That's cool, bro. I'm like crazy.
Oh wow, not bad.
I remember you running out of power fast then, so...
Yeah, he's gonna make it.
I think he's committed.
Yeah, he's making it.
He's committed.
Well, if we fall,
we're not here. Don't go to extreme, remember to save 15% so you can go to 60 if you're running out.
This is where it starts to get hard.
Yeah,
no,
push yourself.
Oh my god, that was scary.
I know, he's sliding.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, I almost made it.
I was pretty impressed.
Not bad, that was pretty good.
How do you feel up there? Like, because you started fast and pumping up, but you ran out of juice.
I don't know if my foot lock is really on point. Right, that's pretty good, though. I'll take it. All
right. You did your best, that's what matters, right?
Who's next? I don't think I'm gonna get high. My upper body strength is shite.
It's going down, but he's coming up.
Yeah, like that. And then, no. Put your feet.
There's the jungle boy.
This is as far as I'm getting. Seriously, I can't get up.
But you were basically doing it just with your arms.
Joey,
I'm cool with.
Joey, I'm not doing it. That'll be my end of the year goals, to climb this.
End of the year goal for Joey.
Yeah, give me some time, bro.
Really great motivation on this is that if you fall, you get really, really jacked up. There was one day when I did it like 10 times on my 10th one, I was at the top and it was the first time I almost lost it. And it became so real.
Yeah.
Because I was all here all by myself with nothing. So I just slammed, I would just been laying there like.
At least I would have helped.
That's just so funny.
Cool. I know this was a different vlog. Sometimes you gotta look for inspiration, and he is a living example of inspiration. Get inspired, do what you love, be passionate about it, and enjoy life. Live it to the fullest. Thank you guys so much for watching. Check out their World Wingsuit League. We got a link in description. I'll see you guys tomorrow.
When Paul was going, there's not like a single person down here even like thinking what's happening.
Just be careful.
Nice work.
There he goes again.